Now let's talk about one of the important second order effect, that is coming out of the MOSFET operation. It is called channel length modulation. CLM. Okay. So what happens is that, as I said, you take a MOSFET. Okay, I am not drawing the gate and all these things. So you take an N MOSFET and you have a channel initially, you know, like this. You, because of the positive voltage at the gate, some channel is formed. Basically this P bulk is being inverted, right? So here also you have some N plus region, but then as you apply more and more VDS, okay, positive voltage, and this S is grounded, this is drain. Okay, let me draw the gate also for completion. When VGS is greater than VT and you apply more and more VDS, we said that the channel is going to get pinched off. It will pinch off like this. Okay, so basically the depletion region was it was extended here. The depletion region was extended like this, and then the inversion layer was shrunk, and then you had the carrier velocity more here because the number of carriers are less to maintain the constant current, and then you said that the channel is basically pinched off because it has actually cut off at this edge and the current remains constant. That's what we said. Okay, so what happens if you increase VDS further? So if you increase VDS further, let me show by the green line. So the channel is cut off like this. Okay, this point becomes even smaller. This point becomes even smaller. Okay. So initially you had a length, channel length L. Okay. Now your channel length has become L minus this point. This point is some delta L. Okay. So initially your channel length was L. Now your channel length has become L minus delta L. Right. And this has become L minus delta L because of increase in VDS. So basically what happens, even when the transistor is operating in saturation, you have some dependence of VDS coming into play. But initially, when we are deriving the current as a first order approximation, we said that, current will remain constant in saturation. But then now we are, seeing that as a second order effect, the channel length is being modulated. Okay. And the VDS effect should come into the, drain current. Okay. So how do I actually put it into expressions? So we have ID is equal to mu n Cox W by L. Let me write ID in saturation because that is what we are talking about. ID in saturation, mu n Cox W by L into VGS minus VT the whole square by 2, right? And we said it is independent of VDS. Now this L is becoming L minus delta L if I keep increasing the VDS. Although I don't have VDS expression, VDS term here in this expression, this L will become L minus delta L. Okay, so let me put L is equal to L minus delta L here. So it is mu n Cox W by L minus delta L. If I take L common, it will be L into 1 minus delta L by L. Okay. Into VGS minus VT the whole square by 2. Okay. Now you see delta L is actually very small. Okay. If you keep increasing the VDS, this, I have exaggerated the situation here, but delta L will be actually very small compared to the large L itself. If it is a long channel device, this delta L compared to L is negligibly small, and you can actually neglect this term and still keep W by L itself, and you can say that it will be almost independent of VDS, it will hold true. But when you come to the short channel device, L itself is very small, okay, and delta L by L will be small, but not as small as that of a long channel device. Okay, so what happens is that this particular term will actually significantly affect my current. Okay, so what I do is, I rearrange this expression. I know that mu n Cox W by L, you know, let me call it ID under channel length modulation. Okay, and this is ID, normal ID. So the regular ID without channel length modulation is mu n Cox W by L into VGS minus VT the whole square by 2. So let me write this ID here, you know, divided by 1 minus lambda L by L. Okay, this is what I get. So I take lambda L by L to the numerator, it is ID into 1 minus lambda L by L whole power minus 1. And as I said, this lambda L by L will be actually very small, because lambda L is small compared to that of the L. So by binomial expansion, you can, you know, approximate is like ID into 1 plus lambda L by L, right? So this is the expression that you have, and you know, this is basically what we are expecting, but then we don't know how much this delta L is varying, right? We don't know, you know, this is happening internal to the device, and this is the physics of it. But then we want to classify all these in terms of IV relationship when you want to give a current expressions for to be implemented in the SPICE model, okay, for doing any circuit simulation kind of thing. Okay, so what happens is that empirically, what I mean by empirically is I see that this is happening from the physics. Okay, but I am not able to derive from the physics in terms of voltages. So rather what I do, I observe this effect and substitute some parameters in terms of voltages so that it gets satisfied, you know, according to what happens in the physics of the device. Okay, so I can rewrite this as ID into 1 plus this lambda L by L. I am replacing it by the term, you know, sorry, delta L by L. This is delta L by L. You know, if I had said somewhere, you know, delta, you know, lambda instead of this delta, forgive me, it is actually lambda L by L. Sorry, I'm sorry again, it's delta L by L. So this delta L by L is, represented as lambda VDS. Okay, and this lambda is called the channel length modulation parameter. So let me rewrite here 1 plus lambda VDS. Okay, so delta L by L is length by length, is a dimensionless quantity. So here also lambda VDS should be a dimensionless quantity, right? And this lambda is channel length modulation parameter. Modulation parameter, and this lambda is in voltage inverse. The unit of lambda is in voltage inverse. Okay, so the final drain current expression will look something like this. ID is equal to mu n Cox W by L into VGS minus VT the whole square by 2 into 1 plus lambda VDS. So now I know, you know, now I hope that you know why, you know, this 1 plus lambda VDS came and how it came and all these things. Okay. And remember, this lambda is channel length modulation parameter, is expression volt inverse. Okay, so how does it affect your last signal behavior? So earlier you had, without channel length modulation, for increase in VGS you had saturation currents going on, you know, parabolically varying like this, right? So it will go, it will have this, and basically you had a parabola here having the line VGS minus VT, and everything above that parabola you had, you know, I'm talking about a long channel device, because you know this is assuming it is saturation. If it is velocity saturation, it will start saturating even before. Okay, but just for an example, let me take it, and then for different values of VDS you will have saturation conditions like this, and current will remain constant. This VDS versus ID, current will remain constant in the saturation region. So this is saturation from this spot onwards, and this is linear, right? So current will remain constant in the saturation region, that is what we said. Now because of this particular term, okay, because of this particular term, you know, this particular term is coming because of the channel length modulation. You know that current should be a function of VDS, and how it varies now, it varies like this. There will be a slight slope. That is what you would observe, okay? And what happens because of the slight slope? So what? Okay, you had a slight slope. That how it affects you, okay? So we had seen that. Let me draw it here only for the sake of completion. So we have seen that if suppose you don't have any kind of channel length modulation, the small signal MOSFET model will look something like this in saturation. How does it look? So this is source, this is gate, and then you know this is open because IG is zero, and then this voltage, let's call it VGS, okay, and then you have some dependent current source which is GM VGS, okay, and this is drain and this is source. You can even connect these two. This is how it looks, we said. Now if it looks like this, so what will happen if you connect an input voltage here, let's say I'm connecting an input voltage here Vin, and then let's say I'm connecting a load resistor here RL, so what will be the gain? Gain is this, see this this current, this is the output voltage V naught, okay, so this current is entirely flowing into this RL, okay, so voltage V naught will be equal to minus GM. VGS is nothing but Vin itself, because it is connected, Vin is connected here, the voltage here also will be Vin, okay, because no other resistance or no other current flows here. So GM times Vin multiplied by RL, so V naught by Vin is equal to minus GM, RL is the gain, okay. Now if I have channel length modulation, how this particular small signal model will vary? So this is coming from derivative of the current with respect to the gate source voltage, and there should also be a derivative of the current ID, because input side you should take derivative of current IG with respect to gate source and drain source, but IG is zero, so input side both are zero. Output side you have to take a derivative of the current with respect to VG, which is the dependent current source, and derivative of current with respect to VD, which is another parameter, and we said earlier it was not there, so derivative with respect to VD was zero. Now since it is there, there will be a finite quantity when you take derivative with respect to VDS, okay, and that quantity will appear as some resistance R naught here, okay. So what happens if this is without channel length modulation? So if R naught is there, the gain will change as V naught by Vin is equal to minus GM RL parallel R naught, okay, and RL parallel R naught will be definitely smaller than RL itself, right, because parallel combination of resistors will be smaller than the individual resistors value, okay. So this is with CLM, okay. So if you have a channel length modulation, the gain will be reduced, okay. So if you don't, if basically if you have channel length modulation, even without connecting any load, your gain is limited by GM R naught, okay, GM R naught will be your gain, that is a self gain. So this slope is 1 by R naught, okay, 1 by R naught, so GM R naught will be your self gain of the transistor, okay. So if you have a situation where you have a slope in the output characteristics, you can clearly say that it is having smaller gain compared to that of the no slope, you know, quantities. So remember this, we'll be using it somewhere while deriving the inverter and other things. Okay, this is all about the channel length modulation effect.